chapter cash book. Chapter number is 11 and this is our third last topic. So the question that I have selected, that is from your own book. Page number is 11.65 and question number is 50. See students, I have already told you the petty cash book, this is very easy to maintain. Why? Because we have just only to transfer the transactions and amount. No calculation is there, nothing special treatment is there. See, even as I have already told you that we have to start our petty cash book with the amount that is already given in the starting. So see, you have to write down the date, then to cash, then the amount that you have received. Right? Then our next step is to record all the expenses. See students, date wise you have to write down the expenses. Like on 3rd April there is cartage, then buy cartage, then on 4th buy bus fare, then postage and so on. The next step is you have to write down the amounts of those specific expenses. See, you will see how I have maintained separate columns for expenses. Why I have made these? Because as you know that the expenses which are of repetitive nature, we have to record them in a separate column. So that is why, see, conveyance is occurring two times, one time here and there. It means it is occurring two times. That is why I have maintained a separate column for conveyance. Right? Then printing and stationery, then postage, wages, cartage and miscellaneous. See students, the expenses which have not been recorded in these specified columns that we have to record in a separate column, that is called miscellaneous expenditure. So after recording all the transactions as well as the amount in the respective columns, you just have to make a total of amounts column. See, the total of amounts column is 7800. But the amount we have received is 10,000. Then find out the difference. If we were having 10,000 balance in our hand and the balance after doing all the expenses is 7,800, it means we are still having 2,200 cash in hand. So this is how we have to maintain petty cash book. Just record all the expenses once, then transfer the amounts in the respective columns, which if they are of repetitive nature, then just make total of amount column and find out the difference. So, I hope you have understood this. So, one question of the similar topic I'll send you as homework. So, please try that at your homes and send me advice. Thank you so much.